Hey Spuddies, Potato McWhiskey here, and welcome back to Let's Play Civilization 6 as Norway. Looks like Machu Picchu has been built by Cleopatra. Might get some benefit from that if we ever conquer her. Ruh-roh, there is a trireme in the neighborhood. I'm not sure if Viking longships can win in a one-on-one with a quadrireme. They do have 30 melee strength over 25, so it's a maybe, I think. It definitely can't win against two, however, and a second will just spawn, so I guess I'm gonna run away. Let's actually pick up a bit of gold for one of our luxuries. Oh, she has all of the luxuries that I have. All right, so I'll get 111 or 117 gold from Dido for my salt, which is gonna allow me to upgrade both of these archers. And since I now have two horsemen online, I'm going to want to do that and start getting everyone in position for the war. I'll pick up another horseman. I think three horsemen is when I'm going to declare the war. I don't see him building any walls, so I think we're good for now. I'm going to try to keep things on the move, though. It's time to go ahead and get you to hide, too. Oh, come on. This is too good of an opportunity not to take it. This isn't when I want to declare the war. It's going to give him some time to get himself together. But I think in order to steal this settler, it's absolutely worth my while to declare the surprise war. I'd really like to not take the extra grievances, but I think just for the sake of being able to nab a free settler, it's 100% worth it. Even my Viking longships weren't in position to hit Cologne. And we can use Cologne as a jumping off point. Cleopatra wants to buy a bit of my strategics, and I don't need that many of them, so I will take that because that gold will help fuel my army. I got +1 era score for researching political philosophy, which is brilliant. It means I can plug in one of these governments. Now, you could make the argument for oligarchy so that I could get the extra unit experience. I don't have a whole lot of land melee units. It might be worth it if I transition into swordsman to switch to oligarchy, but for now I'm going to plug in autocracy, because that's just going to give me a bit more in terms of yields, and it opens up a lot more of the actual cards over here. I'm going to plug in strategos, urban planning, maneuver to be able to build cavalry faster, and conscription to save a bit of cash. Right, let's start hitting Cologne with these units a little bit sooner than I had planned. Now, there is room for a city right here, but, you know, I don't really think it's worth settling. I think it's better to maybe settle another city just somewhere else. And so that's what we're going to do. Get everyone starting to move up. This is, again, we're kind of being forced into war a little bit sooner than I had hoped, but I'm sure this will work out. Right, let's get to work on games and recreation, which will lead to military tactics, which will allow me to build encampments faster. I'm not sure if I'll actually plug that in, but I think it's a reasonable direction to go. Alternatively, you could make the argument for mysticism to get another envoy to send to one of these guys. And you know what? Cahokia is ripe for another envoy. Get another hit in on Cologne with my warrior and go to the next turn. It's a lot of barbarian units running around inside of Germany's territory. I feel kind of bad for Germany. It's kind of going the way that Greece did last series. But there we go. We now own Cologne. The unfortunate thing is I'm going to have to move Magnus. Although, it depends on how quickly I can grab Warlord's Throne. Yeah, it's going to take a bit of a while. Let's keep the city and see what the loyalty looks like in here. It's actually not too bad, only -2.8. So if I can get a unit to just garrison it, I think we'll be just fine. And considering these longships don't really have anything else to do, they may as well garrison it for the meantime. Right, let's start getting more units up and into the fray. Let's see if we can kill this warrior. Oh, there's an archer there. Of course there's an archer there. Of course there's an archer there. Probably about time I turned on yield icons so I can make some better decisions. I think I'm going to settle this city on this plains hill. And it'll also provide a little bit of loyalty pressure. That'll make my life a bit easier. I kind of wanted to kill these guys, or at least to start an attack on them this turn. But we're going to have to maybe wait until we can get both horsemen in. In fact, I might even step back here to draw them forward. Right, there's mysticism, great prophet points, great scientist points, and the oracle are unlocked. None of that stuff is something we'll be using though. We're going to go ahead and keep you moving on. You head there. And you head there. All right, let's kill this warrior with my warrior, and then kill this warrior with my horseman, and then kill this archer. Oh, that is a swordsman. Let's not do that. Okay, this is bad news bears. Maybe I can use this Viking longship to prevent the death of my horseman by baiting this archer to shoot it. I'm hoping that works, and then I'll just keep this guy steady. Right, now is about the time we get to work on Games of Recreation, because I'd like to pick up Defensive Tactics to be able to pick up another Governor title. Now, I can't build a unit in here because I don't have enough... I could, because I didn't actually move Magnus, so I could maybe get my hands on Swordsman if I went to research it. But let's just get another Horseman for now. Well, we got that Envoy from researching the Civic. We'll plug that into Cahokia, which will give us a little bit of extra gold. Jesus H. Christ, that is a lot of archers hanging around here. Now, they stepped forward to shoot the hell out of my warrior here, so let's get him to run back. We'll get this guy to step forward. You need to retreat and you need to retreat. And I need to get my archers up here to help out in clearing out all this nonsense. Hopefully, actually, they might opt to shoot the city rather than my troops. That would be the big, I don't know what the word I was going to use there, but like the big advantage, or it would be a big advantage if they were to do that for me. We'd get a bit of damage on the city without having to do anything. Now, I'd also like to see if I could maybe pick up a few pillages with my scout here running around, because I get extra value from pillaging as Norway. All right, my Viking longship is healed up, so I'm going to send him over here to see if maybe he can get a bit of damage on these quadrireams. China wants to do a bit of a deal. I'll sell him my Diplo favor. I guess I'll just do open borders. No, he doesn't want to do open borders because he's not happy with me. All right, there's shipbuilding, so we can embark now with the scout that I had planned to send over here, but now he's on a pillaging mission. Right, let's get to work on ironworking because we have that iron and we may as well use it. Although that said, there's an argument to be made for going straight for Berserker, so I think I'm going to work on currency to head towards mathematics, to head towards military tactics. Right, let's settle this city here. Now, it is a little bit negative on the loyalty front, but if I can get it growing fast, it'll provide me with extra loyalty for Cologne and stuff like that. Let's kill this. I'm not going to kill the archer because I'm hoping that Germany wastes the time trying to kill that archer. Instead, I'm going to shoot his swordsman and see if I can't get my other units in a position to help out. I'm kind of tempted to try to kill this encampment because it's kind of in my way. So if I could get this killed, I'd have a better angle. Because right now I've only got a too wide lane that I can kind of funnel units through. Whereas if I got this open by killing this encampment, yeah, it'll be pillaged, which kind of sucks. But it'll allow me to push through with ease. All right, let's go ahead and start pillaging this. We get a bunch of faith out of that. Brilliant. Let's keep grabbing as many horsemen as we can while we have Magnus in this city, because I might have to move him if the loyalty over here gets a little bit too hard to deal with. Now, it looks like he cleared out the barbarian units, sort of, and we're going to kind of grind our way through this encampment, but I think I can kill it this turn and take it out. And now I've opened up the front, so I should really get more archers. That's the thing that I'm kind of lacking right now. And they're kind of expensive to purchase, but I am tempted to buy another one. Because I really just need damage that I can do without risking health. Another pillage here for another chunk of faith. I'm not really sure what I'll do with that faith. It might involve purchasing a great general. That'd be the ideal situation, I think. Right, so he's pushed forward with a chariot and he leveled up that swordsman. Let's start taking bites out of his units. I'm going to take a promotion here to be better at attacking ranged and siege units. And here I'm going to take a moment to heal. I really should unlock swordsman class because I can upgrade this guy into a swordsman. Yeah. I should have been unlocking ironworking. That was a mistake on my part. So we'll go ahead and pick that up. Now, I expected Germany to have a much smaller army, so I'm having a bit of trouble dealing with him right now. Anyway, we got that stuff pillaged. Let's see if we can pick up this mine here as well. Yeah, there's quite a few people denouncing me because I got a lot of grievances from declaring the war. For now, let's pick up garrison so this guy can do a little bit more damage and we'll focus fire down that guy. I'm worried about this horseman dying unless I can get units over here to kill this archer. I'm thinking of sacrificing my spearmen to get this kill, because that'll give me the boost for military tactics, which is all that spearmen is really for. It'll almost certainly die as a result of that, but it means I get to keep my horsemen alive. Ooh, there's a traitor over here that I could pillage as well. I'm going to want to see if I can hunt him down. Amazingly, this spearman actually survived. So I'm going to take anti-unit damage on this particular archer, and this archer will be more focused on anti-building or anti-district damage. I'm going to have the warrior. I'm going to have this horseman park in the city for loyalty for the meantime, while I slowly move this archer up. You need to fall back. Maybe I'll park you here. I'll bring this horseman up. Can I get damage on this guy? almost able to get a kill. Can I shoot there? No, I can't. So I think I'll just hold this position for now. I'll pick up this pillage. That'll give me a bit of science and gold. Brilliant. There is the quadrireme in the shallow water. It can't actually hit me. It can't get out of the shallow water, I believe. So I think I'm just going to pass it by and run away. All right, so swordsman killed my spearman as I'd hoped, which means I can step this archer back into the city where it'll do 10 extra damage, which means it'll do a total of 35 combat strength damage. And then this archer, now that he's been softened up, will do slightly more damage as well. And then I can swing in, surround this swordsman and kill right there. Like so. Now that we have iron working, I'm going to work on currency again. I want to head towards military tactics so I have it boosted. And that means I'll also be able to upgrade this guy to a swordsman. It'll cost me a bit of gold, but that's fine. So now I have another unit that's quite strong to help with this war. I have another horseman heading on the way. It might be a good idea to just pick up another archer to send over there. It'll take a while for him to reinforce, but I think it's worth it. All right, let's pick up defensive tactics. I'd like to get my hands on Victor. All right, this swordsman is trying to hunt me down, so I'm going to see if I can chase down that traitor. Oh god, run away, little scout. There's a quadrireme that does not have your best intentions in mind. Or best intentions towards you, or best interests in mind. Never, ever, ever accept a demand from the AI. All right, there's currency. We're not going to be placing down any commercial hubs just yet. But let's go ahead and park you right there. We've got to deal with this spearman, and I think it's going to involve this archer stepping... Oh, this is... Feck. This is like a marsh tile or something, which, if you're not on the road already, means it takes a full movement point. Well, let's just fortify up. This spearman doesn't do that much damage in combat, so if we just fortify up, we'll be able to take a shot next turn. Right, we grabbed ourselves a builder in Alisund, and I think there's a farm triangle somewhere here, and there's a farm triangle here. Let's go ahead and plan out these farm triangles, just so I know in future not to put districts on them. And the question is, do I want to do a farm triangle this way? Well, I think the holy site's going there, so the farm triangle's going this way for sure. And the reason we want to pick up these farm triangles is because we're trying to get enough farms down to pick up feudalism faster. Feudalism is a great civic to pick up when you're going for a militaristic game because it leads to mercenaries, which allows you to upgrade your units for half the price and for half the strategic resources. Anyway, since this is probably going to be a holy site here, I'll just head up that way. Now we have the granary, we have the monument, we got a builder in here. I think we'd like to get our hands on an encampment. Now it would mean buying a tile, but I think that's okay. Looks like Egypt killed Geneva, which makes it actually easier for me to take with Viking longboats. Right, so I think I'm going to get to work on an encampment because it's important to get those great general points rolling fairly early. This city has built basically everything it's going to need for the at least near future. Let's pillage this trade route over here, an extra 60 gold. It's not a huge amount, but more importantly, it helps me and hurts Germany. And that's more important than anything being like super, like really big power spikes or whatever. Of course, I'm going to refuse your demand. Get out of my face. Right, let's step forward with this cavalry. We'll step forward with both of these archers as well and take shots on this warrior. And then we'll get the kill on whoever's closer to leveling up. Oh, we already got the kill. So I think it's time we cleared out this barb camp because it's causing me some problems. It'll also get me a bit of error score and gold, which I think is a fairly reasonable outcome. Right, this city is starting to go independent in 3 turns. That means I'm going to have to go ahead and move Magnus over there to buy me... Sorry, in... That was the wrong city I moved him to. I need to have him in Cologne, and that'll buy me a bit of loyalty time in here. And I guess I could always, in theory, build units over there, but we'll keep producing maybe a couple of extra archers in Nidaros to fund the war. All right, pop a farm down right there on that wheat tile, and this is definitely a tile that we want to work in this city because we want the city to grow, because it's not working high food tiles right now. And now the city has a couple of population in here and a few districts and stuff like that, production isn't so important, so I don't mind getting that little bit of extra culture, especially since culture is my weak point right now and I need to get a bit more of that to catch up. Some good exploration happening over here. We'll know exactly where people's cities are for war. Oh, Jesus. It looks like they managed to... I think they built a swordsman and it stepped forward and murdered one of my units, which is a bit unfortunate. We'll step this archer back and take a shot anyway. I'm going to just need more units, I think, before I'm really going to make a huge difference here. Also, they managed to get a great general. That was probably the big swing that was making this difficult for me. and I did not manage to get a great general. However, I'm not far from one, and I could use this faith that I'm accumulating to get one as well. Let's also kill this scout here. I need to just get rid of any of the nonsense and noise that's happening. All right, a swordsman came out of the woodwork to get my scout. I'm going to get him to run away. I'm an idiot. Why would I put my unit here? There's just quadriremes everywhere. All right, Thebes is coastal as well. That's good information to have. A lot of oh my god, are you kidding me? A quadrireme came out of nowhere and attacked my horseman and killed one of my horsemen. That's really, really unfortunate. I'm surprised at how well he's holding considering how small his army is on paper. Now, something that's really important here is I need to block any units from getting back into his capital. So I'm going to be positioning appropriately for that goal. Let's go ahead and step you into the forest. Bring you out because you have the promotion that lets you do more damage against these. So you're going to attack that to get a bunch of damage on. You're going to shoot this for experience. And then you're going to clean it up. And because I softened it up, you're not going to take much damage. Brilliant. Okay, so we're in a great position so far. We got ourselves a replacement archer. I'm going to need more archers. In fact, what I really need to do is I need to go up here into my government and swap out the maneuver card for the Agog card or Agog or whatever people say it's called so that I can build archers a little bit quicker. Because right now the big problem is I just don't have enough ranged DPS to sort of help deal with some of the problems I'm having. We'll plug another farm down here in Alisund. That'll give it two really strong growth tiles, which will allow it to grow really, really fast. Run away, little scout. China wants to buy some of my horses and I'm going to let them because I just need a bit of money. Right, so what happened there was this swordsman attacked this horseman who was ready to promote. So that was perfect for me. I'm going to take the courser's promotion and then this swordsman attacked this horseman, which is also perfect for me. Now, I could start getting damage on the city or I could clear out these swordsmen. And I think clearing out the swordsman is a good move. So let's step you back. Let's pull you forward. You kill there. You drop back into the city to heal. You step forward to start doing ranged DPS. And then I'm going to do... Well, the actual catapult isn't really that big of a threat. So I think I'm just going to attack the city to get a bit of damage going on it. And then I'll get these horsemen on the left to heal up while this archer moves up. Right, so their swordsman did a huge chunk of damage to my swordsman. But that's not a big deal because I can step this archer forward, kill this... Or at least get him really, really hurt to the point where I can kill him here. Move this horseman to here. Promote him with the courser's promotion. Pull you back to heal. We're starting to sort of take him apart. And this guy will soon be at a level where he'll be able to start doing real damage to the city. We've got two archers on the way. I'm going to get a third one just to make sure we have enough. And of course there's a quadrireme in the Fog of War. I'll go ahead and attack that. Right, I'm going to pop a farm down for Christiansand because that'll give it an extra housing because it already has a pasture. So that'll allow it to not only grow faster but also grow taller. And I think just for the sake of reference, this is going to be farms as well. We've got quite a few farm triangles going on here in my empire so far. I'm kind of connected to make this into a much larger farming area to connect these farms together, but I'll kind of think about that one for now. We found China at least, and a couple of their cities are coastal, which again is a really big advantage because if it's a coastal city, I'll have a bit of an easier time killing it because I already have a bit of a navy and I can transition into a navy fairly easily. Now, I'm a little bit light on era score, which is worrying me. So I'm kind of tempted to use my envoys to maybe generate a bit of era score by getting a suzerainty of, for example, Buenos Aires. Ideally, I wouldn't be picking up Buenos Aires as a thing because they don't really do anything for me. I guess it does make my bonus resources a little bit more valuable. I mean, I think in total I'm picking up two extra amenities, so it's not awful. I don't really see a whole lot of value. I guess the only other place I would really consider putting my envoy would be in Antananarivo. So I'm going to plug it into Buenos Aires to get suzerainty, to get myself a bit of era score. Now I could also potentially levy. I'll hold on to my gold for that and I might need to pillage a bit to get that as well. But if I can levy them, I'll not only get an army, but I'll also get a bit of era score out of that. So we'll kind of see how we're flying. We've got a few turns. If I can take the capital, I think I'll get quite a bit of era score from taking their capital. All right, this is a big problem. This catapult is trying to get into the city and I need to stop it. But he has me blocked off in a very specific way. So I'm going to step this archer forward, take a shot on this swordsman. Step this horseman to here. I'm scared of losing this horseman to this kill, but I think I have to do it. Archers are taking their sweet time to get back over here. Now, I could trade with Antananarivo. This would be a very dangerous trade route, but it would get me an envoy with them, which is worth quite a bit of culture. I'm on a time limit to whether or not this gets pillaged if I do this, but it would get me a lot of gold and some culture, and my capital has already grown reasonably well. So yeah, I think I'm going to go for Antananarivo because it's going to get me an envoy with them as well as some golden culture. It's actually got me 3 total culture now. Right, Bergen is growing nice and big to be able to supply loyalty to these cities over here. In the meantime, I think I'm going to get it to maybe build archers as well to get a bit of reinforcements a bit closer to the front line. I'm going to see if I can get this scout to do a circumnavigation of the world in time for the next era, because that'll get me a bit of era score as well. It's one of the advantages of playing Norway. You can kind of pick when you pick up the circumnavigate thing. I'm going to be sending my scout in this scout in the other direction to try to also pull that off. That looks like we ran into Aminotaur, eh? Very interesting. Right, this city is losing about half its production, which means it's not building stuff very quickly because it has low loyalty. But I think if I were to start on, for example, a horseman, it might be done in a useful amount of time. I don't know, though. Like, part of the problem as well is this city just needs to grow a bit. Could really use a granary and a builder, but I need things that like support my win condition. And I think just getting another horseman or something. If I'm going to build a swordsman, I'm going to build it in Nidaros. Although this swordsman only costs 4 iron, so I'll at least start one over here. I think that's a reasonable thing because I have the card plugged in. So it's almost like the city has only a 25% production penalty. Okay, brilliant. My plan worked. I managed to actually drive this catapult away from the city, and I'm trying to do that to prevent him from garrisoning the city. If I can prevent the garrisoning of the city, then I have a huge advantage in terms of combat strength when attacking Atkin. I'm going to take a moment here to pillage for a bit more faith, because that'll give me enough faith to be able to purchase a great general, which will also provide me with more combat strength for my horsemen. Now I can pillage this entertainment district for a bit of a heal on this horseman, which I am going to do. And I don't see any farms around that I could pick up for a heal as well. So this horseman's probably going to just stop off here to pillage that and then run home. We'll also get a kill here on a barbarian quadrireme and pick up a promotion too. Right, there is the Petra and +1 movement for all naval units. We're also going to pick up the Embalon promotion, which is +7 combat strength versus naval units on this guy. That'll make him a bit stronger in naval combat. Right, another catapult appeared and we want to try to take that out. Can I bring enough strength to bear? I think I can. If I take the shot, I would like to promote him this turn, but if I take the shot, it should be a fairly clean kill, as well as getting me a promotion and a heal on this guy. Right, we've got a second archer in range of the city. We can start slowly chipping away at it, and also pillaging the holy site, I believe, should actually make the city easier to destroy. In fact, I'm going to pillage that next turn. I'll pillage this first. Oh, I can't move up there, but I want to pillage this next turn. But getting that pillage there gives me a lot of gold, which means I could maybe consider buying another archer. I mean, I already have 4 archers on the field. Is 5 too many? On the other hand, I could purchase like some buildings and stuff like that over here. All right, I think it's about time we started working on the harbor. As much as I'd like to build a swordsman, the harbor is important. I think it could also be worth purchasing the library here to get a little bit of extra science and a little bit of extra great people points towards great scientists. That's going to help me keep up technologically and make war easier. All right, let's keep going. See if we can circumnavigate the world in time to prevent the Dark Age. Kind of requires Nubia to give me open borders. Let's see if they're amenable. They demand 1 gold per turn off me, which kind of sucks, but I can kind of see where they're coming from. I am a bit of a warmonger. Right, let's go ahead and shoot Akin with one of my units. I want to pop up here to get this pillage because that'll make the city have a lower combat strength. I shouldn't have actually shot first. I should have shot second. You're going to take the incendiary's promotion. You're going to take the corsair's promotion. You're going to pop back into the city to heal. You're going to pop out to begin attacking the city next turn. We can't get a full proper surround on the city, but that's not a big deal. It'll recover health every turn, but next turn we should be able to do a significant amount of damage to it. All right, that's really unfortunate. They managed to get a spearman into the city of Akin. But we are in position to do a bit of damage to the city. It's going to slow me down a lot. I don't know if I'm going to be able to kill the city particularly quickly now that there's a spearman inside it. And it also means I can't park an archer right beside the city because the spearman will punch it. And I'm also a little bit worried about hitting it with my horseman now, but I'm not that worried. Let's just get as much damage on the city as we can this turn. It's okay if I lose a horseman or two. We can always get them back. Right, we're working on feudalism now. Ideally, I would get myself another builder before I worked on feudalism. So I might pivot away and build military, grab military training first, just to get me a little bit more time on getting maybe a builder out somewhere. And I'll probably grab a second builder here in Kristiansand. I have 4 farms up already. So I just need 2 more. And I think one of them is going to go here and one of them will probably go somewhere else as well. I'm not sure exactly, but we should be able to get that all together. In fact, I only need 1 more farm. So in fact, a single build charge will do the trick for me. All right, let's go ahead and keep healing up. We've got the Great General in here. Oh, I should really move that Great... I made a mistake. Ah, okay. This is what happens when you're kind of a little bit scatterbrained. I should have moved this Great General up to make sure that I got the combat strength bonuses on my horsemen. It would have led me to taking a little bit less damage and doing a little bit more damage. It's a small optimization error. It's not going to, you know, destroy the game, but it is an okay, you know, I'm okay with it. You know, I'm okay with the mistakes I make. All right, let's refuse the demand. And we'll go ahead and start moving these archers up to reinforce. And actually, I don't know where I clicked there. in a bit of turn of fortune, this spearman has stepped out of the city. So we should be able to get a bit of a kill on him. Probably might have been a waste to use that archer because he's better at shooting the city. But I kind of wanted just to make sure that if I get this spearman killed, the combat strength of the city is a lot lower, which means I should be able to kill it this turn. And there we go. Now we get the boost towards feudalism because I think there was a farm in the city. So a builder might be redundant in here, but I would like to get the builder anyway to start growing. I'm doing a kind of like less cities, more growth, more tallness and all that sort of stuff at the moment in this game while also going domination. So I think that kind of fits the themes. Right, we grabbed an archer in here. It might be a good idea to pick up a settler. But I also think it would be a good idea to pick up a builder slash monument and get these borders expanding. If anything, I'm probably going to want to move Magnus over here. If I'm building a builder in Bergen, right? If I'm building a builder in Bergen, then I'm building a builder and I'm moving Magnus over because then I can chop out some stuff in this city. Yeah. I like that plan. So we're going to take Magnus. We're going to appoint Victor for having a loyalty bomb. We're going to reassign Magnus over to Bergen. That's gonna let me do that over here. We're gonna repair the monument first because that's worth the most because it gets the loyalty back up to a safe level, and I may as well just stick Victor in Aachen for now. Now I could kill Frankfurt and then leave Germany alive so that I don't get a huge amount of grievances with the other players, and I think I kind of like that idea. Now I've got a bit of a problem. Egypt has a massive army. That's going to be very difficult to punch through. So I might need to transition into settling and teching and building a massive army to hit her. She has pretty good science and culture, and she's like the next logical target. The only other target I might consider would be, what's her face? Dido. But she's in a bit of an awkward spot for me. I would need to have like a navy being built out of this area to send down to take out Tyre. I don't know what the pass down here looks like. Egypt is a far more open target, so I think Egypt is probably my best bet. But if I'm going to hit Egypt, it's going to be with berserkers, knights, and coursers at the very least, and potentially even crossbowmen. So there's going to be a bit of a transitional period, and I think there's going to be a settlement or two on the border here just so I have reinforcement paths, and I'm probably going to want to send trade routes down this way to get roads for reinforcement paths as well. Right, let's get this scout popping around. And oh, we're so close to circumnavigating. Now we have secured the Golden Age, so it might be worth my while to delay the circumnavigation. Yeah, let's make sure we delay that just for a few turns. Now, at this point in the game, because I killed my neighbor and it's fairly early into the game, we could do something very similar to the Persia game where we transition into just like mass settlements. And because we've got plenty of land over here, we've got plenty of land over here. It's all very like densely populated and should be lots of chops and stuff like that. We could transition to that, but I think I like the idea of maybe trying to push for more of a domination victory. That is going to involve settling a little bit, but not quite as much as if we were going for a more passive victory. What I might actually do in Bergen is purchase a monument to get a few more borders growing and then just like mass chop out builders. Let's grab feudalism. I want to get feudalism before that builder comes out. I'll tell you what, I'll just cancel that. I'll just do production saving until I'm ready to build that builder. There you go. That's the best thing to do. You want to buy a bit of my iron. You don't actually have iron right now, and I don't want you to get access to swordsmen because that'll make your cities harder to kill. Now, what I could do is just do a quick war on Dido to grab Utica, which would be basically a free city because it's just isolated. And I could probably also grab Sidon fairly easily, although it does have walls, whereas Egypt doesn't have walls. Right, let's promote Victor with the Garrison Commander promotion. That'll give him extra loyalty to cities nearby. All right, there's double envelopment. Double envelopment is a pretty nice promotion because it gives you extra flanking bonuses. We also grabbed ourselves Sun Tzu here. Now, we could turn him into a great work of writing, I believe, but he's probably better used pushing the war forward. Take a few turns here to heal these units up, and then we'll get the momentum going again. All right, let's get these guys to back up and just wait until the era ticks over before we get that circumnavigation. Couple of catapults hanging around Mainz, so let's start shooting at them. Oh god, I didn't mean to click there. Whatever I clicked on, that was not what I meant to do. We'll position our horsemen in a flanking position to be able to kill this catapult easily. Now, this other catapult will be a bit of a problem, but I think if we bring up this great general, we'll be able to get a bit of damage on him. At the very least, if he does retreat to the city, he'll be hurt. Right, so this archer, I'm going to go kind of send it off to just check on the borders of Egypt to see what they're up to, because I want to know what's going on with Cleopatra so I can kind of plan a war with her. Right, we entered into the medieval age. It is only a normal age, which is fine. Plus one era score there, beautiful. There's the Huey Toakali. I do have a couple of lakes around that I could maybe build that in, but it would be a very ambitious thing to go for, and I don't think it would give me a whole lot of benefit. So I think I'm just going to work on berserkers now that we have military tactics. I'd love to get the lighthouse in here, but I think the sooner I get these berserkers online, the sooner I can get to war with Egypt, because they're going to be a big part of cutting down her army. Now, since we have berserkers and pikemen and all that stuff, it would be a good idea to head up to pick up crossbowmen as well, to be ready for that, as well as using knights as well. I want to have like a mixed army, maybe get a couple of catapults just to have them ready to join the fray. So I think I'm going to pick up masonry so they can build ancient walls somewhere to get the boost for engineering. Although, is that really worth my time? I think I'm making enough science to where that's not worth my time. I'll kind of do it speculatively because it kind of all leads in the same direction anyway. So unfortunately, I didn't actually end up getting a religion this game. It's not a big deal. We kind of went for it, you know. These things happen, you know, but we ended up with a decent amount of faith, which might be able to be used to purchase a couple of great people, for example. So that'll kind of have to decide our dedication. Now, Exodus the Evangelist is off the table. That's the whole reason why I brought up the whole religion thing, because I don't have a religion. I can't get error score from that. Monumentality has something to be said, because I am planning on building a couple of districts. The other one is Free Inquiry. I think Free Inquiry is the most reliable one in my current situation. There is actually a Petra City up here, but I'm not really sure how useful a Petra City would be in a domination victory when I'm trying to just get as much killed as possible. Let's go ahead and shoot this catapult and then take it out with one of these units. I think I'll take it out with you because you've slightly better... Excuse me? What did I click? Oh, there. I clicked on the wrong unit. Anyway, let's cross the river with you. Get you popped in over there and get you popped in over there. We've got the city surrounded so we can start, you know, chipping away at its health. Take out Mainz. I think I'm going to eradicate Germany and then spend a bit of time killing maybe these two cities, or maybe at least one of these cities. Maybe just generally fighting Dido, doing pillaging, running horsemen around inside her territory while I build up for the war with Egypt. In fact, I'm not actually going to build these berserkers yet. I've changed my mind because berserkers are technically medieval era units. And this card does not boost medieval era units. So what I want to actually do is wait until I have feudalism to build my berserkers. So I'm going to plug in here. And I already got the great general I wanted. So I'm going to plug Agog out. And I'm going to plug in the settler card. And limes, because I am researching ancient walls. So I'll get ancient walls somewhere. And then in my capital, Nidaros, I'm going to work on a settler. I'm going to move Magnus over there because he has the promotion that prevents population loss, and that's important for settling, which means I'm glad I switched this monument online, because I'm not planning on getting builders in or chopping out builders in here anymore. If I'm really thinking about it, I could maybe make builders and send them over there and chop out settlers from Bergen. Like, that has an interesting ring to it. In fact, that might be the best thing to do. Well, like, right now, building a settler is about the same as a builder. So I'll work on that. But maybe in Alessand or something, I'll start builders in here. Nah, I'm just going to try to not lose population in my capital. Yeah, I think that's just a better move overall. I mean, the Huey is tempting, but I need to get these cities somewhat repaired. Right, let's start doing a bit of damage to this city. In fact, I might be able to take it this turn, and I can't. Oh, I cannot. Wow, that's really close. Now that we're in another era, I think it's safe to circumnavigate the world. Ooh, I would like that to be light cavalry. I'm going to put a couple of votes in the light cavalry category in the hopes that that passes. And I'm not really caring what this is. I mean, I may as well just plug in jade because it's jade-like, and I think a few people have it or whatever. All right, excellent. So light cavalry passed, which means the primary unit that I'm using is now stronger. Let's go ahead and have this horseman kill the city because he'll pick up probably pick up enough experience to level. Yeah, he did. He picked up enough experience to level, which means he'll heal up. And then we'll take a couple turns just to heal up here before we move on to Frankfurt. Although having said that, our units are like way stronger than they should be right now. So if I get the Great General over here, I'm pretty sure I can kill this in like two turns, depending on how things go. Then I can just get Germany off the map, which I think I'm fine with. We're going to need a critical mass of units, but I'm also torn between building infrastructure. Like, I'm not really sure if I want to build city center infrastructure or if I want to focus on encampment infrastructure and then build units. I can't do it all, so I got to start picking. Like, around when do we want to go to war with Egypt? Because ideally, I would have some units on the way from these cities by the time we want to go to war with Egypt. So that's going to kind of dictate the plan. I tell you what, we'll talk about that next episode. Well, no, that's not fair. I should at least kill Germany. Come on. I should at least end the episode on a high note by killing Germany. Sure. I will do that. Oh, we found Ha Long Bay, which is actually a very nice natural wonder. And we circumnavigated the world, which gives us +5 era score. It's very early in the game to circumnavigate the world, but I'm very happy that I managed to pull it off. Let's go ahead and take the next turn, and then we'll take on Frankfurt again. Get ourselves a Frankfurter. Okay, they're upset that I captured Cologne. I don't think that's going to matter. Hopefully people vote no. All right, looks like most people voted no, which is good. Let's go ahead and get some damage on Frankfurt. Who's ready to level up? I think it would be good to get a bit of extra experience on this level 2 guy. Right, there goes Germany. So that also ties in. People are going to be pretty unhappy with me. But that pulls in another 5 era score. So already on like the first turn of a new era, maybe the second turn, 150 grievances against us with all major powers, which kind of hurts, but that's fine. But already, like a couple of turns into a new era, we already have 10 era scores. So we're well on our way to at least a normal age. I think if I can keep momentum up here and get a lot of these Eurekas and stuff like that, I'll be able to pick up a really, really fast, a really, really like... another golden age is what I'm trying to say. I'm kind of mixing my words up here. I'm getting kind of off into the weeds. Anyway, look, I love you all very much, and I'll see you guys next time. All right, bye-bye.